So, are you ready to become a podcaster on podcasts? Download the Anchor app. It's the easiest way to do podcasting and it's also free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's easy. It's everything you need to make a podcast all in one place. Good morning, my wonderful and beautiful kings and queens. How are y'all doing on this Friday morning, y'all? It is Christmas, so Merry Christmas to y'all. I pray that you are having a nice and fun and staying warm because it is freezing outside, y'all. And some of y'all might still be in the bed, but if y'all like me, you got kids and stuff, you know y'all already up having to put stuff together, do this and do that. So, if that's you, or if you at work today, or, you know, or you just out and about or whatever, you know, let's just thank God that we have seen a brand new day, another Christmas that was not promised to us, okay? And, you know, even if you don't have family and it's just you, you know, thank God that guess what? You're still here. You are still here. You are still living. You are still breathing. You are still here. You got the use of your arms and legs. You in your right mind. You're still here. And even if you don't have the use maybe of your arms and legs, guess what? You are still here. Because there are so many people that did not make it to this Christmas. And they thought they was going to make it, but they didn't make it. So, we still here, y'all. I just wanted to come on here just for a few minutes. I won't keep y'all on today because it is Christmas. And for those of you that don't know me, my name is Candace E. Brown. I'm a podcaster. I am an author. I'm also a YouTuber. I am a mother of two wonderful children. And on my podcast, what I do, I motivate women to get themselves together, to have that self-confidence, to have that self-love, to have that abundant life that God has promised each and every one of us, where we are excelling in every area of our life. Yes, we are queens, we are royalty. And just loving on you and just getting to know you. I do drop a few things for men sometimes, but majority of the podcast that I'm doing in this season is for women because I can relate to women better because I am a woman, okay? So, you know, that's what my podcast is about. And now that we got that out the way, I just want y'all, just want to come on here and say, y'all just enjoy your families today. You know, enjoy yourselves. If you're off from work today, just enjoy your kids, enjoy your family. You know, just make memories. You know, just really make memories. Just laugh and eat and just do just whatever, you know. And I just want you to take a moment and sit back and just, not too long, think for a few minutes, you know, thank God. You know, Lord, I'm still here and I got my family. Just sit back and think like, wow, you know, I have my family here and I'm here, you know. And let's just say a special prayer to those people that have lost loved ones, even in this year or in the past. If you don't have a mother or a father, or if you lost a sister, a brother, if you lost a best friend, you know, let's just keep them in our prayers as well. You know, I don't have my mother with me or my grandmother's with me, but you know what? I thank God that I'm here and I thank God that I'm with my children. So, you know, let's just send out a special prayer. I send out a special prayer to each of y'all. You know, this is for, sometimes, you know, we look at it as it's supposed to be the happiest time of the year. But including with this year, you know, it could be a sad one for you. But I'm just here to tell you, smile anyway. Smile anyway. You know, I know you're crying. I know you're hurt. I know you feel broken. You don't understand why things had to happen the way they happened. But I promise you, the joy of the Lord is your strength. I'm going to say that again. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Yes. That means wake up and God knows you're hurting. God knows your pain. But guess what? Find joy in today. And your joy is knowing that you seen another day that was not promised to you. And you may sit there and say, well, I just can't be happy because they're not here. You can be happy. You can't stay stuck in that rut because that's going to lead to depression. And depression going to lead to sickness. And you're not trying to leave here because you can't seem to get yourself back on track. And I know it's hard. Trust me. I know my mother's been dead like almost 14 years now. And I just couldn't seem to get myself back on track, especially with this holiday right here. This was her favorite holiday. Christmas was her favorite holiday. And every Christmas I was sad and I cried. But up until this year, I knew that I'm like, Lord, I know it's a better way for me. This can't be it. This just can't be it. It has to be a better way. And as I began to get a relationship with God, that's when God began to show me the way. And he would do the same thing for you if you would just allow him to come in and sit with you. Let him allow him to come in and talk with you. Allow him in your bedroom. Allow him in your home. Everywhere you go, allow God to be with you. And he will show you the way. And in due time, he will even show you why things happen the way they happen. And when you begin to see why things happen the way they happen, you would thank God, you would cry, you would just cry out to him, because I know I did. And I'm telling you, I just thank God for just being who he is. And he knows all. You know, we don't know everything. You know, we know at the time moment, we don't know the future. You know, we know the past and we know the present, but we don't know what our future holds. None of us does. So that's why I thank God for being just who he is, because he knows the future. He knows what's ahead of you. You don't know, but he knows. He knows what it was, you know, he knows what's going to happen if this goes this way or this goes that way. That's why he does things the way he does them, you know. And people often say, you know, you can't question God. And I used to get mad because I'm like, well, why can't you question God and why he did this and why he did that? I'm here to tell you, you don't question God. But let me tell you something about him. What I love about him, he'll still answer the question. He will still answer that question. Because I often ask the question, well, why did my mother have to leave? And why did my mother did this? But when I begin to get myself together and focus on my mindset and get my mindset together and reprogram my mind, he still came back and answered that question, because I didn't ask it anymore. When you begin to work on your mindset and begin to change and make that change, you will be done forgot all about, like, well, God, I ain't gonna worry about it no more. And I didn't worry about it anymore. I let it go. And he answered my question, and I was like, wow. I said, my God, look at that. And I hadn't asked it anymore why she left me. No, I at times like, Mom, I know you had to go, you know, that's the will of the Lord. And I would leave it at that, and I miss her, but I didn't dwell on that question. And it's like God just showed me, you know, why she left and why she had to leave. And that's what I love so much about him. I love him so much. And he knows the desires of your heart. So I just want to encourage those that have lost loved ones. It's not the end. Okay? It's not the end. Death is not the end. You know, you don't have to be sad today. You can smile. And I know it hurts. But as time goes on, and as you begin to get a relationship with God, things get better and better and better. I promise you it does. But you have to commit to doing the work on you now. You have to commit to doing the work. You can't say, okay, well, I'm waiting on the Lord to just heal me from all this hurt. And you just sitting there not doing nothing. No, you got to do the work behind it. Faith without works is dead, okay? Faith without works is dead. That means you got to put some work behind it. It says faith without works. You have to work. You got to do the work on you. You got to work at it. You can't just sit there and think it's going to fall in your lap, because it's not. You have to do the work. As long as you do the work and you stay consistent and keep God first, I promise you it'll happen. So I'm not going to hold you guys long. May you all have a merry, merry Christmas. And until next time.